Artist Happy Thursday. It's our Character Creation Thursday. I have a really fun character creation challenge planned for you today. So let's get into it right away. Set it up with the moving and grooving, okay?
Hush, not child. Might understand you by and by. Just move on up toward your destination. Though you may find from time to time complication. So hush not, child, and don't cry. Your folks might understand you by and by. Move on up and keep on wishing. Remember your dream is your only scheme, so keep on pushing.
Because let's do a breath work. We haven't done breath work in a long time. Let's do an inhale for 7, hold for 7, exhale for 8. All right? Ready? And inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A third one. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For the middle guys, you can move your hand on your belly. Make sure you're really inhaling. Our third, fourth one, I believe this is. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And our final one, inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I hope that was bad. Sometimes when I like interrupt myself, I get off on my numbering. So that's what I do. All right, so we have this. I have today's character creation day. Have a really, I hope, fun character creation and challenge for you today. What we're gonna do is you're gonna look at a video of a voice actors doing voice acting and actors who have played more than one character with their voices. So we're going to look at John Leguizamo, Tom Holland, Stephanie, and Beatrix, who just did Encanto, who people who acted to more than one occasion do voice acting. And we're going to look at that video, and then we'll come back for our character creation challenge for today. So let's take a look at this video.
Spies in Disguise, Tom Holland, Will Smith, is very, very funny.
Sometimes an actor's talents extend beyond the screen and into voice work. These are the actors who put their voice talent on display multiple times to bring some of your favorite animated characters to life.
At some point, these words that I'm saying are going to be turned into an animation that will be a character that will have a face, that will say, have my voice.
Number 1. Stephanie Beatriz nailed her role as Mirabelle in Encanto.
I'm part of the amazing Madrigal.
But it's not the only character she has voiced. She can be heard in Ice Age Collision Course as the dino bird Gertie.
Where is he? When I'm through with that one-eyed weasel, he's gonna need two eye patches.
As well as the voice of General Sweet Mayhem in the Lego Movie 2.
Nothing left to do except sing a mature, sad song as we fade to black.
The scar on her right eyebrow was actually from falling into her Legos as a kid, so it was fitting she got to voice a character for the movie. Beatriz stated that she had always wanted to do voice acting, and that she would record herself doing a pretend radio show in different voices. Looks like that practice paid off.
My favorite thing about voiceover acting is that you're really only limited by your imagination.
Number 2. Let's talk about Bruno. John Leguizamo provided his voice for the iconic character, playing alongside Stephanie Beatriz's Mirabelle.
Embrace! To make the candle bright, you have to embrace her!
But it wasn't the first time the two actors starred together in an animated film. Leguizamo can also be heard in 5 Ice Age movies as Sid the Sloth.
Could you help me, please? My nose is dangerously close to my butt.
He must have a knack for playing oddball characters, and he does it really well.
And these voices just become so free, and the more you do it, the freer you feel. And
Number 3. Sandra Oh has a lot of experience recording her voice work from home, as she did when voicing Ming Li in Turning Red.
I know it feels strange, Mimi, but I promise nobody will notice a thing.
And Varana in Raya and the Last Dragon.
You saw a dragon.
This provided a whole new set of challenges for the acclaimed actress, as she had to deal with connection issues when trying to communicate with the crew of the film. Oh had a blast playing these characters, and we had a blast watching them.
So it was a great opportunity just to be able to put that on screen.
Number 4. The talents of Tom Holland continue to impress us, as he proves his skills stretch beyond live action and into voice acting. Holland voiced the nervous Ian in Onward.
I'm not testing anything! Just let me go!
The nerdy Walter in Spies in Disguise.
Can it work?
It hasn't yet, but maybe. Here we go.
And Jip the dog in Doolittle.
I wasn't actually that bad. That came out way better than I thought it would.
Holland stated that laughing actually gives him the most difficulty behind the mic.
If you ask me to cry, fine, I'll cry all day. If you ask me to, like, have a hysterical laughing fit, I just can't do it.
His solution was to find something funny that he could genuinely laugh at in the studio, and then the creators just used that laughing audio throughout the movie. What did come easy to Holland, though, was barking like a dog.
His superhero name is Dog Dog.
Number 5. Awkwafina has really been stretching her vocal talents over the last few years. She voiced the titular dragon Sisu in Raya and the Last Dragon.
Hello? Hello?
As well as Miss Tarantula in The Bad Guys.
It's crime time, baby. Shark!
We need a distraction.
And Courtney in the Angry Birds movie, too. Awkwafina has enjoyed both the perks and challenges of voice acting.
And I don't really realize it until I hear it back. And I'm like, who's that, Satan? Oh, it's me.
Maybe it's a coincidence or a pattern, but all 3 of these roles have been mythical-like animals. We wonder what creature she'll voice next.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. That's nice, yeah.
Number 6. Alan Tudyk is a voice legend, especially at Disney Studios. He voiced King Candy in Wreck-It Ralph.
Detapify this monster so we can see what we're up against here.
Alistair Cray in Big Hero 6. Duke of Wesselton in Frozen, and Duke of Weaselton in Zootopia.
It's Weaselton. Duke Weaselton.
And let's not forget his oddly specific catalog of voicing animals who don't talk. like Pico in Encanto, Hey Hey in Moana, and Tuk Tuk in Raya and the Last Dragon. The cherry on top of all of this is that he can also be heard in Ice Age, playing Chali.
My stomach hates me.
Number 7. Kelly Marie Tran doesn't have a lot of voice acting credits, but the ones she does have are impressive. She voiced Raya in Raya and the Last Dragon.
That was awesome. Give me some show.
As well as Dawn in The Croods: A New Age.
Every mark is adventure.
Bringing her bright and energetic personality to the roles.
I get to play Raya both in her younger years and her older years, and it's been it's a dream.
Yeah. Number 8. Comedian Jim Gaffigan proved his vocal talents when voicing Luca's father Lorenzo in Luca.
Luca, you remember your uncle Luca.
Prior to this, he also voiced Van Helsing in Hotel Transylvania 3 and 4, as well as starring alongside Zendaya in Duck Duck Goose as the character Peng. Gaffigan hasn't done a ton of voice work, but he nailed all three of these roles, proving he is more than just a live-action actor. Number 9. Dwayne The Rock Johnson impressed everybody in 2016 when he turned in a great performance as the demigod Maui in Moana.
The gods have given me a man!
He also proved he had some singing capabilities with his iconic song, You're Welcome. Johnson loved playing the role as he connected with the Polynesian setting and characters.
The opportunity to showcase my culture.
His other voice acting role as Crypto the Superdog in DC League of Super Pets is a bit different, and continues to prove The Rock is a talent that thrives in the various roles he plays. Number 10. Bill Hader is a hilarious comedian that brings his energy to all his voice acting roles. He voiced Fear in Inside Out.
Worst scenario is either quicksand, spontaneous combustion,
Flint in both Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs movies, Leonard the Pig in both Angry Birds movies, and this unfortunate slug monster who was late for class in Monsters University.
I always felt bad that they would be on frame for exactly 3 seconds and then they would cut away and I go, ugh.
Number 11. Scarlett Johansson has only voiced a few animated characters in her time, but they've all been pretty big roles. She voices main character Ash in Sing 1 and 2, Nutmeg in Isle of Dogs, Ka the Snake in the Jungle Book live-action remake,
Yes, would you like to see?
And Mindy the Mermaid from the original SpongeBob SquarePants movie.
Here, take this!
Number 12. We all know Zendaya voiced Lola Bunny in Space Jam A New Legacy.
We'll get your son back. I promise.
But she had also done some voice work prior to that role. She voiced Michi in Smallfoot, and in the same year also voiced Chi the Duckling in Duck Duck Goose. We can't wait to hear who she voices next as she continues to add to her impressive resume. Number 13. Frozen 1 and 2 are two of the most popular Disney films ever, and Kristen Bell had a hand in bringing them to life, voicing Princess Anna in both films.
I did it all without powers, so, you know, I'm coming.
In between her turns as Anna, Belle made a cameo in another Disney film, Zootopia, playing Flash's equally lethargic sloth co-worker, Priscilla. Outside of the Disney bubble, Belle lent her voice to Jade in Teen Titans Go to the Movies.
That was amazing!
Number 14. Another actor whose voice appeared in Zootopia is Jenny Slate, who played the secretly evil Assistant Mayor Bellwether.
I never get to do anything this important.
Along with this role, she also voiced Gidget in The Secret Life of Pets, Harley Quinn in the Lego Batman movie, and Ted's mom in The Lorax.
Ted, honey, don't play with your food.
Number 15. Ben Schwartz is an incredible talent who voices all of his characters with the grace of a gazelle. He voiced the clumsy Banarnar in the Lego Movie Part 2, shining in his quick appearance. But his biggest role to date is Sonic the Hedgehog in both movies. While we don't actually see him during the live-action bits, his voice brings the CGI character of Sonic to life. They actually used his facial expressions as reference for the character.
So I kind of brought that heart and energy and comedy into it. That's kind of like my version of Sonic.
Number 16. Soul number 22 in Pixar's aptly named Soul film was voiced by comedy legend Tina Fey, which explains why the character was so naturally funny.
All that stuff is in your body.
10 years earlier, Faye was voicing Roxanne Ritchie in the underrated gem Megamind. Number 17. Jamie Foxx has had a great acting career, so let's not forget about the times he lent his voice to animated characters. Foxx starred alongside Tina Fey in Soul, playing Joe Gardner, the unfortunate musician.
Would you stop? I have something to tell you!
He also voiced the tiny bird Nico in Rio 1 and 2.
Relax, baby bird, you can catch the next one.
Number 18. Brad Pitt is one of the biggest and most well-respected movie stars in the world. His first animated role came in 2013 as the titular Sinbad in Sinbad and the Legend of the Seven Seas. 7 years later, he would return to animation as Metro Man in Megamind, and then follow that up the next year as Will the Krill in Happy Feet 2.
Of the world!
Number 19. Jack Black's acting range is, as his character Poe would put it, legendary. Black voiced the endearing panda for all three Kung Fu Panda films. He is yet another actor on this list that can be heard in Ice Age, as he played the saber-toothed tiger Zeke.
I see the sloth, and he's got the baby!
You can also catch him as Lenny the Shark in Shark Tale. Number 20. The Fresh Prince himself, Will Smith can be heard starring alongside Jack Black in Shark Tale as the main character Oscar. His only other voice acting role was as Agent Lance in Spies in Disguise.
Pretend like you're a normal person talking to a much cooler normal person.
Who knew some of our favorite on-screen talent also voiced so many of our favorite animated characters? Which actor plays the most of your favorite characters? Let us know.
Okay, good. And one thing that was, I hope you enjoyed that, guys. One thing that I really noticed when I watched it, I wondered if you did too. Actors use their bodies a lot. You know, they're not just standing there at the microphone in the recording booth. They're really animated with their bodies. They really physically get into the character to the best of their ability. I wondered if you noticed that. So let's go to our character creation challenge. All right, guys, is our character creation challenge. The character creation challenges that I give you every Thursday, they're what I use to decide who will get the Amazon card for the following month, right? So also, guys, we're doing another fall showcase at the end of October. So the scenes you send me will end up in our fall showcase. I'll select some of them for the fall showcase at the end of October. So I really want you to commit to doing these, guys. Some of you guys, you can also use these tips on your YouTube channel. Though some of you have channels. I also send these to Carmel from time to time so she can see your progress. I really challenge you to do this every week, the same way you're doing Picture This and the same way you're doing the film scoring for Alexander. I want you each week to film yourself or have someone in your house film you and send it to me each week. These are your acting challenges, all right? So we just saw this great video about voice acting. So your character creation challenge is you're going to create two specific characters, all right? So your scenes are, could be about counting the gold, walking into a cave, or sailing on a ship. So that's me, you pick two. Is again, counting gold, walking into a cave or living in a cave or sailing a ship. And you're gonna pick two of them. And then you can create a character that goes with each one. So let me give you an example. So the two I'm going to pick are counting the gold and the cave, all right? So my first character for counting the gold And guys, don't worry if you don't have props or whatever, just mom it. So my first character for counting the gold might be out a little windy. He's like, I hope I have enough coins to go to market today and buy some milk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I hope this is enough coins to buy some milk. Okay, so again, I use the coins and I created a character, an animated character. The little lady who wanted to go to market to buy some milk. All right. So again, so we're counting the coins. The second one I picked is the cave. So I would create a completely different character. All right. So for the cave, I'd be like, nobody can come into my cave because it's mine. That's why I growl really loud. Anytime someone comes near my cave, I growl and I scare them away. Because nobody can come near my cave. Okay, so I created two completely different characters. The little old lady recounting the gold and the monster who didn't want anyone coming near her cave. So that's what I want you to do. You're gonna take what, choose two out of three. So either the cave, the gold, or the boat, right? Put me on the boat and you're gonna create two completely different characters. Now guys, don't worry about props or anything, because they're kind of still imagining. You're doing this as a voice actor, and you're creating me, but this way, filming you in your studio, all right? But I still want them on video. They don't have to be long, so send me your two different characters with the two different scenarios, and send them to DEJClass@gmail.com. You can text your video to 323-364-2478, or you can send it to me on our Facebook group. Again, every Friday I will send out the trivia questions and the reminder for our character creation challenge for today. You'll get that in my email tomorrow, all right? Because I really encourage you to do the challenges that I have done. The challenges have, it really helps you grow as an actor. So, let's end it the way we begin it, with the more moving and grooving, okay? Swear you hit me like a vision, I wasn't expecting. But who am I to tell fate where it's supposed to go with it? Don't you blink, you might miss it. See, we got a right to just love it or leave it. You find it and keep it, cause it ain't every day you get the chance to say. All right, guys, thank you.